What comes to your mind when you hear the word corruption?
When I hear about corruption, what comes to my mind is that about tax evasion, about bribery.
Can you give at least 3 examples of that corruption?
Bribery is that if you intend to a position in the government, if you are a license and if you don't have any connection in the government, you cannot be accepted to the point that some will bribe money, give money to the person in order to get the position in the government. And the second one is tax evasion.
How about the third one?
The third one? The third one is when somebody caught you, the policeman, even if you are, that person is driving and they are going to get your license even if you don't. If you did that, do a crime, they are going to get your license, and if you will not do that, they are going to ask money.
What do you think are the solutions to this problem?
It's very difficult, the solution, because it is already implanted in our government that corruption is all over the world, even in another country. It's very difficult. There is no solution.
Thank you so much. What comes to your mind when you hear the word corruption?
For me, corruption is when government officials or anyone who has authority take money or favors from people illegally.
Can you give at least 3 examples of corruption?
3 examples. I think one example is when usually traffic of officers, like they catch some traffic violators, those jaywalkers, and then these jaywalkers, traffic violators, they give bribes, and then the police takes them, and then second, for example, if a person, or let's just say a rich person, wanted to some government officials to do them favors, so they give them money, like secretly under the table, and then these government officials will do them favors. What else? Third, corruption can be like, for example, let's just say those who are in the higher positions, and then they would ask for favors in exchange for something, like for example, at the airport, and then there are people or foreigners who have like drugs in their bags, and then they just give money to the officers there, and then the officers will just let them enter the country because of that. So those are some examples.
What do you think are the solutions to this problem?
Yes, I think first is really the values. Like I think all people, especially those people in the schools, in the students in the school, it all starts with the values. So values should be taught as early as possible so that when these kids are grows up, they will be honest. I think our people should be honest, and there should also be strict rules about this. There should also be strict punishments for those who do this kind of thing, to do those who are corrupt. They should be punished by law. That's it.
What comes to your mind when you hear the word corruption?
Corruption for me is when a bad people and the government were dishonest and greedy.
Can you give at least 3 examples of corruption?
First, when a mayor gets the budget for the people and spend it for himself or his family. Second, when the government accept money illegally. And lastly, when the police accept the money and release a criminal.
What do you think are the solutions to this?
Should punish the corrupt officials harshly.
First question is, what comes into your mind when you hear the word corruption?
Corruption, actually, if you would define corruption under the law, this is defined under the Anti-Corrupt and Corrupt Practices Act. And in this law, it enumerates actions of government officials that tend to prejudice the government, and it's associated with some kind of an arrangement where the corruptor and the corrupted, normally the corruptor is the private person engaged in government contracts, and they would conspire to defraud the government of the funds intended for public projects. And another thing is, when you want to facilitate something that is against the law, bribing. When the word corruption is uttered, normally there is that immediate idea that this involves bribery of government officials by a private person to facilitate their business with the government, especially with the officials who is influential in making his project possible.
So, can you give at least 3 examples of corruption?
The 3 examples would be, I have a contract with the government, and I bribe somebody in government that the materials I'm going to use would not be within the quality provided for, so that malaki ang aking ginansya. So that is one example. Another thing is, when I want to bribe somebody in the agency of the government to facilitate my contract so that I can win in the bidding of that contract, and we would tamper with the bidding. So that's one second example. And the third would be to call this abuse your power so that the parties concerned will be compelled to give money for his business to be done with the government. So these are the 3 means by which corruption could be exemplified.
So for the last question is, what do you think are the solutions of corruption?
Yes, in order to minimize corruption, especially in government transactions, we require that the transaction should be transparent. That means the public knows what it is that are being the subject of the contract of people. And the other one is to punish those who are committing corruption by enforcing the law against them. And with the example, they will be afraid to engage in corruption. And to prevent it, there are other means, like orienting the people of getting involved in projects for the government, so that they will not, accomplish their projects below the standards required by the law.
What comes to your mind when you hear the word corruption?
The first thing that comes to my mind whenever I hear the word corruption is that some powerful people are engaged in dishonest or illegal acts in their transactions.
Can you give at least three examples of corruption?
First is bribery, when you receive gifts in exchange for certain favors to do some illegal acts. Second is when you are dishonest, when you don't declare the proper taxes that you should pay, and you evade it. And another one is when you extend favors to certain people. Let's say, for example, when it comes to building of government infrastructures, roads and bridges, and you have a hidden transaction or agenda for your own personal benefit with the contractors, it can be also an example. So it's a dishonest and an ethical act.
What do you think is the solution for that?
Oh, it requires joint efforts for everyone involved. Like, there must be a stricter enforcement of policies and laws. In case of violations, there will be stiffer penalties. And we have already good laws. The problem is when it comes to the implementation of these laws. So we need to have more strict implementation to regulate the behaviors of public officials.
Thank you so much.